869 points for Huffins. So that will certainly keep him at the top of the table as we await the performances of the last heat of the evening in the 400 metres, which of course includes Dan O'Brien. But Huffins ran well. And there's the lineup. Thomas Dvorak of the Czech Republic had a good first day. Dan O'Brien in lane two, the world record holder, three times the world champion. Erki Newell from Estonia. Lev Lobodin of the Ukraine. Francisco Benet of France. Of Spain, I do beg his pardon. And Frank Busserman, this young 21-year-old who's had such a tremendous first day in lane six. Hamalainen, twice runner-up to Dan O'Brien in the World Championships in lane seven. And Mike Smith, the Commonwealth record holder, in lane eight.
Just to bring you up to date with the Huffins' time, remember, he's overall second after the first four events, 48.83, and that got him 869 points. So you can sort of sit on that time and that point score and see if any of the principals can go beyond that here in this final heat. Always the big names in the final heat, and O'Brien's such a talent. He's a one-man athletics team, and such a high quality of performance in each of the 10 events.
I wouldn't mind any of this lot on my athletics team. But Hamalainen there in lane seven, he's got a very good second day to come, including the 110 meter hurdles, where he's superb. The fastest ever time run in a decathlon for 400 meters, believe it or not, dates back to 1968 and the great Bill Toomey, 45.68. And actually, one of Great Britain's former international decathletes, Peter Gabbett, he's a friend of mine, he ran one of the world's fastest as well, just outside 46 seconds. This is the guy that everybody's been talking about here today, Frank Busserman. After his long jump of 8.07, he tied his personal best in the high jump with 2.04. But there's Thomas Dvorak, had a fine day as well. Dan O'Brien, the world record holder. Over 100 points off any world record schedules. But still in control of this decathlon. Erki Newell looking for the best decathlon of his life. Just outside Erki Newell, Lev Lobodin, fine competitor. Heavy strapping on his leg. He may find this 400 meters a little bit tough. He's shaking his head. Perhaps that means that he's not expecting a great run here. Francisco Benet of Spain. Overall, Benet is down in 23rd position, and actually on paper the slowest 400 meter runner here. Then a few final adjustments for Frank Busserman. His best ever, 48.66. Eduard Hamalainen, 27 years old, 47.20, this man. And finally, Mike Smith. It amazes me, how on earth does he drag his huge frame around this 400 meter track after a demanding first day? Well, Mike Smith set those Commonwealth record figures in the famous Goetzis decathlon a little while ago, and when he was there he ran just inside 48 seconds, so he's obviously in good form, but a few indifferent performances today. But this stadium is going to go wild for Dan O'Brien, who will try and extend his lead over the rest if he can run a fast 400 meters. To this, Thomas Dvorak just inside him went away very quickly indeed, trying to chase O'Brien down, but O'Brien holding his own. It's Erki Newell outside O'Brien who's gone off very, very quickly. Erki Newell is a very fast sprinter, but has he got the stamina? Dan O'Brien is eating up the ground now. It's O'Brien at 200 meters. He's really turned it on. O'Brien and Hamalainen and Busserman. Erki Newell hanging on by the skin of his teeth, but listen to this cheer for Dan O'Brien. Hamalainen on the outside is coming through very strongly. O'Brien is tying up.
tied up badly over the last 50 metres. Hämäläinen came through. It's 46.83. That will do very nicely. Just 0.3 seconds outside his best ever. Now that really has put the pressure on the rest. O'Brien has got a very strong second day. The 1500 meters we don't really count. Nobody likes doing that, but as far as hurdles is concerned, discus, pole vault and javelin, he's hardly got any weaknesses. And that performance brought Dan O'Brien 967 points. Compare that with Scott Huffins, who was 850 odd. But Hämäläinen in closing, O'Brien, a very gutsy run. Erkki Nuell in third place, he ran well too. Well, certainly, Stuart, a man who perhaps didn't start today terribly well, but he's come through with a storming finish here.
Yes, he has, and I wait the start of the next day because he's a fine high hurdler. He's run sub 13.5 for the high hurdles, and along with Busman, well, that should be quite an occasion at the first event of the second day tomorrow morning. But O'Brien clearly in the driving seat.